Hello students, we have already discussed Indigo lesson, all important concepts concerned with the Indigo sharecropping, their problems. And now, what is the important thing here? Gandhiji will do it. Now there is a time of justice, because what is the thing here happened? The lieutenant governor of the province had ordered the case to be dropped. Civil disobedience had trumpeted. Here trumpeted means successful. The first time in modern India. So here Gandhi and the lawyers now proceeded to conduct a far-flung inquiry into the grievances of the farmers. So grievances means here whatever the complaints of the farmers, now it will be recorded. So here Gandhi and the lawyers now proceeded to conduct a far-flung inquiry, and now they would go and inquire about whatever the problems who is facing the poor peasants or the farmers they used to face. So it is here observed, and now they will record the grievances, the complaints of the farmers. Deposition by about the 10,000 peasants were written down, and the notes made on other evidence. So here now Gandhiji and the lawyers, they started collecting the evidence, and now that evidence will be collected and it would be recorded in proper way and it will be presented. So here documents were collected, the whole area frothed with the activity of the investigators and vehement protest of the landlords. And now all plan, the blueprint of that plan, now everything it is now prepared, and with the proper plan now they will go ahead. Now next activity, what is that next activity? In June, Gandhi was summoned to Sir Edward Gate, the lieutenant governor. Before he went, he met leading associates and again laid detailed plan for civil disobedience if he should not return. So now here again such type of important things we can understand, right? Negotiation, then courage, leadership qualities, and the leader should not have freedom. If leader will have such type of freedom and leader will have such type of understanding of the situation, then nothing is going to happen. Leading associates and again laid detailed plan for civil disobedience if he should not return. Gandhi had 4 protected interviews with the lieutenant governor, who as a result appointed an official commission of inquiry into the Indigo sharecroppers issue or the situation. So here now the official inquiry commission set up, and who set up that official inquiry commission? That is lieutenant governor. And why it happened? Because of the interviews, because of the communication with Mahatma Gandhi, and Mahatma Gandhi proceeded with all evidences. Now official inquiry will set, landlords they have to answer, that secretary of that landlord association, others also members of that association, they have to answer now this. And because of the inquiry, now what happened next? The commission insisted here what would be the commission would insist. Commission would insist, means all that proofs, and the committee will again insist that you have to face the inquiry. So in that committee, who are there that we can hear? The commission consisted of landlords, government officials, and Gandhi as the sole representative of the peasants. So here we can understand who is there. So here, indigo sharecropping was the problem. And in this problem, here Gandhiji was the representative of the peasant. And here, one more important thing, in that commission consists of landlords. Landlords were also there. Then government officials, government representatives were also there. And the Gandhiji was the sole representative on behalf of peasant. Then Gandhi remained in Champaranya for an initial uninterrupted period of 7 months. So we should have that devotion. Once we will decide to help, suddenly one visit we will go there and we will go back. Do you think that the mission will complete? You will appoint someone to look after that and then suddenly you will go. Whether that person is doing that work, you will not take the feedback, you will not take the follow-up, and you will go ahead. So this should not happen. Then Gandhi remained in Champaranya for initial uninterrupted period of 7 months, and then again for several short visits. The visit undertaken casually on entreaty of an unlettered peasant in the expectation that it would last a few days, occupied almost a year of Gandhi's life. So here, approximately 1 year of the Gandhi's life, here Gandhiji spent in that Champaranya. So we can understand that the influential leader like Mahatma Gandhiji, he spent 1 year to solve such type of problem. But we can understand that how can we win, or how can we proceed with any problem? So those who are great, they are doing such way. So we should also never quit our mission or any problem. Or suppose you are fighting against any person, then think about the justice. So collect the proofs, conveys the message to the authorities, and you will find the result that you can win. Then Gandhi remained in Champaranya for an initial uninterrupted periods of several months, and then further also. So here approximately 1 year we can consider. The official inquiry assembled a crushing mountain of evidence against the big planters, and that official inquiry, that commission, they have collected here the crushing mountain of evidence against. It is the means of the bundle of that evidence, like it is like a mountain for them, and the crushing mountain against the big landlord. But now evidence are there, so they have to agree with the things whatever that commission will tell. And when they saw this, they agreed in principle to make refunds to the peasants. But how much must we pay? They asked Gandhiji. Now it is the Gandhiji's turn to take initiative here and think in the way here. Now here the negotiation skill will work. Dialogue, how to argue, that argument will work. Leadership quality here, the presence of mind will work. So here we can understand. Then they thought it would be demand They thought he would demand repayment in full of the money which they had illegally and deceitfully extorted from sharecroppers. So they have extorted that money, they have taken that money with illegal way from the peasants. So that extortion of money, illegally they have taken from the peasants. So what is that? They have to repay, refund that money. Then he asked only 50%. So here Gandhiji asked only 50% at least you give. There he seemed adamant. So here writes Raven J.J. Hodge, a British missionary in Champarani, who observed the entire episode at close range. So this question may be asked for 2 marks, or in 1 mark also line may be given, or 2-3 lines may be given. So in that also some follow-up questions. They are asking earlier some information, they are asking afterwards some information. So extract best questions we have to prepare. So in that, such type of examples here important. Thinking probably that he would not give way, the representative of the planters offered to refund the extent of 20%, and his amazement, Mr. Gandhi took him at his word, thus breaking the deadlock. So what was actually the initial discussion? He asked only 50%, but in that also, from the landlord side here, the representative of planters offered to refund to extend 25%. Okay, we are ready for 25%. And here Gandhiji means with the presence of mind, he breaks that deadlock. Okay, if you are ready for 25% from my side, it is okay. As a leader of the peasants, I am taking responsibility. Here Mr. Gandhi took him at his word, thus breaking the deadlock. The breaking the deadlock means whatever the issue it was going on, now through this negotiation, through the decision, now the issue is sorted out. And now this settlement was adopted anonymously by the commission, and this is the decision, and because of this decision we can understand, and there would be some question in our also mind that why Gandhiji decided to take only 25%. If he would wait for some time, they may give 50% also, or the whatever the money it would be, the demand and that peasant would get. But the reason it is provided afterwards. Gandhi explained that the amount of the refund was less important than the fact that the landlords had been obliged to surrender part of the money. So now they are obliged to surrender that part of the money. So this is their image, it was spoiled. So this is very important. With it, the part of their prestige. So their image, their prestige now it is not there in the mind of the higher authorities or the commission also assigned that thing. So officially, it will be the blame on them, and then they have to give the refund. Means the viceroy, all high rank officers, they will also think about them with the wrong way. So it was the insulting thing for the landlords, that planters. Therefore, as far as the peasants were concerned, the planters had behaved as lords above the law. So they used to think about the peasants that nothing will happen. Whatever they will say, it is the law. Whatever they will say, it will be the final thing. But now here, it is not happened in this case. Because whatever they used to think with the proper plan, with investigation, with such type of way, here we can understand. Now the peasant saw that he had rights and defenders, he learned courage. So here, peasants learned the courage. Now, peasants learned that how to fight. Peasants learned how to be together and how to lead. So here, this concept now, if we will think in our mind, then we can understand that there means the landlord prestige was there in that area. Now that prestige will spoil, their image will spoil. Hire all officers will also set such type of inquiry on them, and then further there would be problem for them in future also. So here event justified Gandhi's position, and because of that event, now the position of Gandhiji, the leadership of Gandhiji proved, and then that image about the Gandhiji created in the mind of everyone. Officials, they would also think about this influential leader. Within a few years, the British planters abandoned their estates, which reverted to the peasants. Indigo sharecropping disappeared. So here, this indigo sharecropping, it is disappeared. Now they got the justice. So this justice phase is here important, and this is the legal justice. But after getting legal justice, is it only the legal justice is important? No. Other things are also equally important, that is education, their health, then concern with the poverty, and again some more issues are also equally here important. In that, Gandhi never contented himself with large political or economic solution. He was the cultural and social. So here, he observed, means the Gandhiji saw the cultural and social backwardness in the Champaran village and wanted to do something about it immediately. So what was his course of the thing, course of the action? In the next course of the action, we are observing very important thing, that is, Gandhi saw cultural and social backwardness, and he will do something for that people. So this is the all-round development, sustainable development of that area, and it is observed. Then what next here? Now next plan, what would be the next plan? He appealed for teachers. So if teachers are there, then they can get quality education. So somebody should be there who can give quality education. So he appealed for that. And with his appeal, so what happened next? Mahadev Desai and Narhari Parekh, two young men who had just joined Gandhi as a disciple, and their wives volunteer for the work. Several more came from Bombay, Pune and other distant parts of the land. Means with his appeal, so many they were there. In that, here are two names mentioned. One is Mahadev Desai and second is Narhari Parekh. So here, two influential here teachers, they were ready to work voluntarily without any expectation. And here again, and they were the disciples. Their wives also volunteer for the work, and several more from Bombay, Pune, here it is also mentioned. And then Devdas, Gandhi's youngest son, arrived from the ashram, and so did Mrs. Gandhi. The primary schools were opened in six villages. Kasturbai taught the ashram rules on personal cleanliness and community sanitation. Means personal cleanliness, personal hygiene, then social hygiene, and especially here it is about the education. Here it is mentioned primary schools were opened in six villages. So that Champaran area, that six villages, primary schools opened, primary education started. Now there will be change after some years when they will take the education. So this is important thing. So up till this, today we will discuss. In the next video, we will think about the next part of the story.